What if I say to you that we do not use biodiesel in engine? In fact, we use biodiesel plants. This is what we are going to do today. We are going to study what are biodiesel plants, why do we use it, by studying its properties, and what are the major advantages of using biodiesel, and what are different feedstocks for biodiesel production. So if you see biodiesel, it is defined as monoalkyl esters of long chain fatty acids. And it refers only to 100% pure fuel, B100, that means 100% biodiesel, and which meets a set of specific standards. What are standards? These are different for different countries. And Indian standard is IAS 15607 2016, and it is based on these two European and American standards. Let's see that. So this is the biodiesel B100 standards, Indian standard, for fatty acid methyl ester, FAME. And you can see some of its properties which are listed here. Some of the known properties to you: density, kinematics, viscosity, fly point. So the biodiesel which is produced should meet these standards to be used as a blend in diesel engine. Okay, so if you see the definition, it is long chain monoalkyl ester. Monoalkyl ester means it can be methyl ester, ethyl ester, or propyl ester. But the most common is methyl ester only. Why methyl ester is common is that because methanol, which is used to produce methyl ester, is least expensive. But you can also use ethanol or isopropanol to prepare ethyl or propyl ester, which is equally good. So we can produce biodiesel B100 using any of these, and this has to be mixed with diesel to get blend. So blend is defined as BXX, where XX represent percentage of biodiesel. So if B20, then it is 20% biodiesel and 80% petrol diesel or petroleum diesel. So you take B100 and then petroleum diesel, you can mix it, splash blend it, computerized blending you can do, and then you can arrive at desired blends. So what are the common blend level? The common blend level is B20 is the maximum is done till date, and if you use up to B20, then few or no modification is required in diesel engine. If you use B5 or below, then there is no change in user experience. However, for B20, there will be 1-2% decrease in power, torque, and fuel economy. But these changes are usually not noticeable. Let's see some of the properties why we can use up to B20 only. So this is a diagram of viscosity for 7 different fuels. So diesel, soybean oil, soybean methyl ester, soybean ethyl ester, rapeseed oil, rapeseed methyl ester, and rapeseed ethyl ester. If you see viscosity of the oils, this is soybean oil, this is rapeseed oil, these are very high. And if you remember the presentation, we discussed that we do not use vegetable oil in diesel engine because of its high viscosity. Now, after trans esterification, these viscosities are reduced. However, it has still not reached the value of diesel. So why is viscosity important in a diesel engine? Because if the viscosity is low, then it is easier to pump, and it is easier to atomize. That means you can break it into finer droplets for better combustion. Now let's see other properties. That's cloud point and power point, and we have discussed in the earlier presentation also that cloud point of diesel and power point of diesel is low as compared to vegetable oils. Even after trans esterification, biodiesel has higher cloud point and power point than diesel fuel. That means biodiesel will gel in cold weather, so cold weather operation is a problem in biodiesel. Now, another property is flash point, CT number, and sulfur content. So we'll see that flash point of diesel is low and oil and biodiesel is high. Now this in fact is good. If there is an accident, then a vehicle which is run on biodiesel is better than vehicle which is run on diesel. Then CT number, this also we have discussed earlier, the CT number of biodiesel is higher than that of diesel. So it is better. So for biodiesel blends, this can help in better combustion. The sulfur content of oils and biodiesels is very less as compared to diesel, so there will be lesser emissions. Another advantage of diesel is that since the oxygen is part of biodiesel, so combustion efficiency of biodiesel is greater than that of petrol diesel. And also, if there is an accidental spill, the biodiesel will degrade faster than diesel. So there also it is better. Another advantage of biodiesel is that it has superior lubricity. So lubricity is ability of a lubricant to minimize friction between surfaces in relative motion under load. So that means if a higher lubricity is there, then there will be less damage to surface. So if 1% biodiesel is used, then it can increase the lubricity of diesel by 65%. So it's better than diesel in that aspect. And also for emission part, if you see life cycle emissions of carbon dioxide, then for B100 it is 78% less as compared to petroleum diesel. Since we use blends, so B5 will have lower carbon dioxide emissions. Since this is a linear variation, so B100 to B5 is 20 times. So that means 78 by 20 will give you somewhere around this. Let's discuss emission of other constituents, NOx, particulate matter, carbon monoxide and hydrocarbon. If you use biodiesel, then the emissions of particulate matter, carbon monoxide and hydrocarbons are reduced, whereas there is a small increase in nitrogen oxides. So if you use B20, then nitrogen oxide increase by 2% to 4%. But if you use B5, then increase is negligible. And this diagram has been taken from EPA. Now, the net conclusion is the biodiesel blends can be used for B20, for any diesel engine, even for advanced fuel injection systems. There is no reduction in reliability or durability, and maintenance requirements also remains identical. Now, in fact, if you use biodiesel blend instead of 100% diesel only, then you have certain advantages. For example, lubricity, then you can have higher CTA number, lesser emissions. Let's discuss how you can get enough biodiesel. So for getting biodiesel, you need any of these, either vegetable oil or plant oil or animal fat or waste oil. So from this, you can get biodiesel. Another important source is algae. And if you have seen national policy on biofuel, which I have sent you earlier also, and it is available on the net also, that our blending level is close to 0.1% only. So B5, B20 is still way higher. And biodiesel from algae is written as third generation fuel. You need to refer to this policy for more on this. I have shown these some pictures here so that you can have certain idea that how does Jatropha, Pangamia and soybean, rapeseed canola and oil palms looks like. And there is very interesting story that in Canada, they have improved the properties of rapeseed and oil is produced. So this is Canadian oil. That's why canola is, this name is there. Now this is a microalgae which is grown in raceway ponds. So all algae cannot generate biodiesel. So you need a special algae. You need to study it. And based on different sources from how you generate biodiesel, you can name, for example, soybean methyl ester. If you generate biodiesel from soybean, then you can call this, and so on. Now, in addition to esterification, when you produce biodiesel, you may do some pre-treatment, and also after transesterification, you need to distill it to take out alcohols. Can be recirculated, and this is the separation of byproduct glycerol. And then to reach to the desired properties of biodiesel, you may again need to do transesterification and then distillation, separating, and finally you will get desired biodiesel. But there are still challenges. For example, as I mentioned earlier, there's only 0.1% blending in India, so you need enough feedstock oil. Different branches are needed to get to that, and yours being one of them. Then you want to use higher blends, then you need engine and emission optimizations. You are needed there, and then research is also needed in cold weather operation of biodiesel, because you know it gels in cold weather. These are the links from which I have taken the images. Then these are some additional questions this you need to find out. Sometimes acid catalyst is used during transesterification, and normally we use base catalyst, as I mentioned, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide. Then what is pre-treatment of vegetable and why it is done, that you have to find out. Then why higher amount of catalyst is used during biodiesel production than stoichiometric requirement. That's all for today. Thank you very much.